इन दिस आर्टिकल वी हैव टू फाइंड द एंगल बिटवीन टू लाइंस इफ एल वन एम वन एल एन वन एंड एल टू एम टू एन टू बी द डायरेक्शन कोसाइंस ऑफ एनी टू लाइंस एंड थीटा बी द एंगल बिटवीन देम देन cos theta is equal to L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2. Here we have to find the angle between two lines. So let us suppose that let PQ and RS be two lines in the space with direction cosines. Direction cosines L1, M1, N1 and L2, M2, N2. Let us suppose that there are two lines. Suppose that this line is here PQ and suppose that this line is here RS. And the angle between the line PQ and RS is theta. Let theta be the angle between the lines PQ and RS. Here we suppose that there are two lines PQ and RS in the given space and L1, M1, N1 be the direction cosines of PQ line and L2, M2, N2 be the direction cosines of the RS line. Let theta be the angle between the line PQ and RS. Now we draw here, suppose this is Z axis and this horizontal line is X axis and suppose that this is Y axis and here O be the origin. Now we draw a line OA which is parallel to PQ. So here OA is line through origin and parallel to PQ. And draw another line OB, OB which is draw another line OB which is parallel to RS and parallel to RS and passing through origin. So draw lines OA and OB which are parallel to PQ and RS respectively. Here we draw two lines OA and OB. OA is parallel to PQ line and OB is parallel to RS line and these two lines OA and OB passing through the origin. Draw lines OA and OP which are parallel to PQ and RS respectively and passing through the origin. So here we suppose that there are two lines PQ and RS in the given space. Here L1, M1, N1 be the direction cosines of this line PQ and L2, M2, N2 be the direction cosine of this line RS. Here theta is the angle between the line PQ and RS. We suppose that theta is the angle between PQ and RS. Now we draw line OA which is parallel to the line PQ and passing through the origin. Draw another line OB which is parallel to RS and passing through the origin. So let us suppose that there are two lines PQ and RS. The direction cosine of PQ be L1, M1, N1 and the direction cosine of RS line be L2, M2, N2. Let us suppose that the angle between PQ and RS line is theta. Now we draw two lines OA and OB. Here OA line is parallel to PQ line and passing through the origin, and OB line is parallel to RS and passing through the origin. Now we know that since theta is the angle between PQ and RS, so theta is also the angle between OA and OB line. So here we write, since theta is the angle between the lines PQ and RS, so theta is also the angle between the lines OA and OB. Since OA and OB are parallel to the lines PQ and RS respectively. Here we can see that theta is the angle between OA and OB because OA is parallel to PQ and OB is parallel to RS, and it is given that theta is the angle between PQ and RS, so theta is also the angle between OA and OB. Now we know that the coordinate of origin B 0, 0, 0. So, and let us suppose that let coordinate of B point are x1, y1, z1 and OB is equal to R. We suppose that the coordinate of point B is x1, y1, z1, and the distance between O and B, that is OB, is equal to a small r. Now we find out here this. We know that x2 minus x1 upon x2 minus x1 upon PQ is equal to L. Y2 minus y1 upon PQ is equal to M, and Z2 minus Z1 upon PQ is equal to M. Since we know that this is the formula for direction ratios, this is the relation between the direction ratios and the direction cosine. So we using here this formula. Here suppose that this is x2, y2, z2, and here 0, 0, 0 is x1, y1, z1. And PQ is the distance between O and B here. And the direction cosines of OB line are L1. Suppose the direction cosines of OB line are L2, M2, N2. Direction cosines of OB line are L2, M2, N2. So we find here. X1 minus 0 upon OB, this is equal to L2. Y1 minus 0 upon OB is equal to M2, and Z1 minus 0 upon OB is equal to N2. So we can write here x1 minus 0, that is x1, and OB is here small r, is equal to L2. Y1 upon small r equal to M2, and Z1 upon small r is equal to N2. So from here we can write x1 is equal to RL2, y1 is equal to RM2, and z1 is equal to RN2. Now we find here projection of OB on OA line. So projection
of OB on OA line. In yesterday, we find the projection of a line on another line. Projection of a line on another line. So now we find the projection of OB line. Projection of OB line on OA. Now we find the projection of OB line on OA. So projection of OB line on OA line is, here we write, this is x2 minus x1, that is the direction ratios of OB line. So x2 minus x1, x2 is here, x1 minus x1 is here, 0, multiplied by the direction cosines of the line OA, that is L1 here, plus y1 minus 0 multiplied by m1, plus z1 minus 0 multiplied by n1. This is the projection of OB line on OA line. Since we know that if we find the projection of a line on another line, so we first find direction ratios of OB line and then multiply direction cosines of OA line and then adding. So x1 minus 0, this is x1 multiplied by L1 plus y1 m1 plus z1 n1. We know that here projection of OB line on OA line can be written as x1 minus 0 multiplied by L1 plus y1 minus 0 multiplied by m1 plus z1 minus 0 multiplied by n1. Here L1, m1, n1 be the direction cosines of OA line. L1, m1, n1 be the direction cosines of OA line. And x1 minus 0, y1 minus 0, z1 minus 0, these are the direction ratios of OB line. Now we put here value of x1, y1, z1. So we can write here x1 is equal to r l2, so we write here r l1 l2. Y1 is equal to r m2, so we write here r m1 m2, plus z1 is r n2, so we write r n1 n2. Now taking common hand r, we get L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2. So this is the projection of OB line on OA line. Also we know that here theta is the angle between the line OA and OB. Now we find here projection of OB line on OA. This can be also written as OB cos theta, and OB is here equal to small r, so this can be also written as r cos theta. Here we find the projection of OB line on OA line in two way. Here the projection of OB line on OA line is r times L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2. And the projection of OB line on OA line can also be written as OB cos theta, where theta is the angle between OB and OA line. And OB is equal to small r, so projection of OB line on OA line equal to r cos theta. So comparing these two equations 1 and 2, we get r cos theta is equal to r times L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2. So this R is cancelled out. So we get here cos theta is equal to L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus N1 N2. So this is the angle between two lines if the direction cosines of one line is L1 M1 N1 and the direction cosines of the second line is L2 M2 N2. Now, if A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2 be the direction ratios of the lines, then actual direction cosine, actual direction cosines can be written as.
Now we find here the actual direction cosines. If A1, B1, C1 be the direction ratios of the line PQ and A2, B2, C2 be the direction ratios of the line RS, then here we find actual direction cosines. So L1 can be written as A1 divided by under root A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square. M1 can be written as B1 upon under root A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square. And N1 can be written as C1 upon under root A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square. Similarly, the actual direction cosines of the second line RS can be written as L2 is equal to A2 divided by under root A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. And M2 is equal to, here we write B2 upon under root A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. And N2 is equal to C2 upon under root A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. Now we put value of L1, M1, N1 and L2, M2, N2 in the above formula. Cos theta is equal to L1, L2 plus M1, M2 plus N1, N2. When we put here value of L1, L2, M1, M2 and N1, N2, we get A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 divided by under root A1 square plus B1 square plus C1 square and under root A2 square plus B2 square plus C2 square. So this is the angle between the two lines if A1, B1, C1 and A2, B2, C2 be the direction ratios of the given lines. Thank you.